On in Nepal, fresh violence and killings have been reported as the Madhesi protesters in that country observe the 100th day of an agitation against the country's new constitution.
Now, the protests over the last 3 months have left 50 people dead and hundreds injured. Supplies from India, which are critical for Nepal, have remained cut off, leading to severe shortage of fuel, drugs and other medicines in the country. The new Nepal government has held talks with those leading the agitation, but so far they failed.
Fresh violence in the plains of Nepal, areas close to the Indian border, in protests over the country's new constitution. These protests have now completed 100 days. Two more people died in the violence on Saturday in southern Nepal, pushing the death toll in the agitation to over 50. The latest incident in the Saptari district, when Nepal police fired into a mob after they were attacked with petrol bombs and bricks, while trying to clear a crucial highway occupied by those who say Nepal's constitution is unfair to groups that share ethnic ties with India.
ऐसा है कि एक तरफ समझौता की बात करता है ये सरकार और दूसरे तरफ गोली की बात करती है.
Meanwhile, on the Indian side of the border, at this crucial crossing at Bihar's Raxaul town, 5,600 trucks carrying essential supplies, including fuel, into Nepal have been stuck for over 2 months. Crippling life on the other side of the border, including in capital Kathmandu, forcing Nepal to turn to China for help, blaming India for cutting off supplies and helping the protesters. The Indian government has said it has nothing to do with the protests. Reacting to the latest round of violence in the country, an External Affairs Ministry spokesperson said, distressed at loss of life in police firing in Saptari in Nepalese Terai last night. Political solution required. But with the violence continuing, it seems people in Nepal will have to brace for more hardship in the days to come. With agency inputs in Patna, this is Alok Pandey, NDTV.